by Brendan Dillon. Behind the net, set back by Carlson. And Namestnikov took a high stick, and Scheifele is going to go after Hague. Mark Scheifele fighting Nick Hague, who takes him down. Namestnikov jumps right back up. There was a penalty coming to Vegas.
This is going to be interesting. First, let's talk about Josh Morrissey had his gloves off in this game, standing up for a teammate. You don't want it, but you love it. Scheifele drops his gloves instinctually, standing up for a teammate because of that hit. That's an elbow. That's a dirty one from Hague. We're going to wait to see. I won't be surprised whatsoever to see this at 5 in a game. Oh, boy. Man, penalty trouble all night long for Vegas. They've been shorthanded 5 times, and I think they're going to be facing a 5-minute from here from Hague. Although, look at the way his wing was tight to his body, and yet he drives up into the head of Namestnikov. Team toughness all around. Rick Bonus has preached it, talked about it. They just haven't. And he's got the 5 fingers up looking for the big one.
Here's Brandon Blandina.
We have a 5-minute major on the play to Las Vegas.
Sorry, that was John McIsaac, but it is a major.
Yeah, those ones don't usually get the benefit of the doubt. Listen, they're going to review this now. The one thing I'll say that the argument for Vegas would be that Hague had his elbow tucked to the side of his body, and you got a much smaller Namestnikov. But he drives his body upwards and follows through the head of Namestnikov. This league has gone out of its way to protect its players, and rightfully so. There's Namestnikov down low hunched, and you can see the follow through with the arm from Hague after the hit. Yeah, he lunges into the head. You know what? That's the right call. He lunges into the head, and you've got a player that's vulnerable. Watch right here. Bam, right there. He targeted that head, in my opinion, from that view. I think this is standing. This is a 5.
Great looks at it. And you just hope that Namestnikov is fine. He hopped right back up, but you never know with those kinds of hits. So they're getting things ironed out. The referees tonight, John McIsaac, who made the call, Brandon Blandina, the other ref, Mark Schuchik, and Scott Cherry are the linesmen. All this with 8:37 left on the clock, and again, the Jets' power play will be under the microscope.
You know what, Dan, it sounds funny to say, but the power plays have been 5-1 in favor of Winnipeg, and now I think they're going to go to a 5-minute major situation. It could have been more. I think the refs have missed another couple of calls. There's been a high stick on Adam Lowry that didn't get called earlier. There was one on Sandberg as well. Let's take a look at those. Our production truck always on their toes. Our producer Kevin Pratt finds it with Justin Newell quick. Look at that high stick on to Lowry. He was upset about that earlier in the game. And then Sandberg right there. Look at that one. Clipped his face. It's a quick game, and referees have a really tough job at hand to try to catch those ones in a blink of an eye. Lots of power play opportunities for the Jets, and man, oh man, what kind of pressure you wonder that they would feel with a 5-minute major in a tie game where their power play hasn't been able to find an answer.
It is 0 for 5 tonight with 12 shots. Cassidy Dom Ducharme to his left, Joel Ward to his left on the Vegas bench. Just a quick summary. Dorofeyev is 12th in the first, from Carlson at 15:56, and Monahan from Ehlers and DeMello at 3:31 in the second. Those are your goals.
Don't forget, too, is Brad McCrimmon, the general manager of the Vegas, or pardon me, Kelly McCrimmon. I'm sorry for that, folks. Of course, that's his late brother. There's Kelly McCrimmon, the general manager of the Vegas Golden Knights. Former owner, general manager, and coach of the Brandon Wheat Kings. Got to be wondering what he's thinking, along with his coach, Bruce Cassidy. I'm going to say, keep in mind, this power play will go without Mark Scheifele, as he's in the box as well.
Good point, Kevin. So it's taken a while to get things aligned. There, Scheifele went right after Hague. We talked about it off the top of the show in our pregame. Craig Button talked about special teams, and you did too. Now they're going to make another call.
After video review, Vegas 14 has a minor penalty for illegal check to the head.
Oh,
I'm surprised. I'm surprised.
So was Rick.
Yeah, so was he. When you look at that replay, his one thing you can say, his arm does not come up, but what does happen is he drives upward with his legs, and to me, he targeted that head. He knew. He looked away from the puck and right at Namestnikov, who was vulnerable, and he drove through the head. I am really surprised, considering the way the league has made sure they've gotten these head contact calls right. I don't get paid to make the calls.
So they're still doing some housekeeping down at the penalty box. Brad Lauer talking things over with Rick Bonus. So for the Golden Knights, it was a 2 and a 5.
So where you think it's going to be a 5-minute major power play for the Jets, it's going to be 5-on-5 hockey. Vegas gets 2 and 5. That'll be Hague. And the Jets, Mark Scheifele, will get 2, 5, and 10 for what I think is going to be an instigator call. Mark Scheifele is going to head to the locker room here. His night's over. He's going to have something to say about it.
He'll go to John McIsaac. So, yeah, with 8:37 left, not enough time for Scheifele to come back in. He'll plead his case.
Yeah, Rick Bonus at the bench here is looking for an explanation here as he's got John McIsaac. What a swing of momentum. This is where you rally as a group, right? So you got your top line centerman standing up for a teammate, right? Gloves are off. I don't know if that's an instigator. He comes in, hanging the, drops the gloves at the same time. You're not really, I thought it might have been a minor, to be quite honest with you. It wasn't much of a fight, probably minor, offsetting minors. Instead, he gets 2, 5, and 10. Wow, what a swing. I'm surprised.
Yeah, I'm thinking roughing minor as well, but as it is, as you said, Kevin, 5 skaters aside right now, and we're finally ready to go again. Face-off win by Lowry.